Hi, I'm Patrick. The whole idea of these particular sessions and videos are basically to help you understand how to go about cracking the CAT exam. So I normally solve the questions in the exam very logically, and that's what I'm going to explain out here. So when you solve it logically, you can be really fast in the exam and you can solve a lot of questions. I've explained it by solving other CAT questions, and it's the third video from the slot one where I'll be explaining you some more sums where all the questions in the CAT exam, almost all the questions in the CAT exam, can be solved without using great formula equation. What is important is you need to just practice this method. It's not that very difficult. I've seen a lot of students, also people who are really weak in maths, doing really well with regards to logical methods. So I had a student who had scored less than 45 percentile in CAT maths and managed to score 99 plus and get into. And then I have many such examples. But what is important is you need to be able to change from what you already know to what you can. And this is applicable not only for people who are weak, but also people who are strong. I mean, there are people who have improved even after scoring a 99, they've gone on to almost a 99/900 as such. So what is important is you should be able to change the way you solve. Anyway, so with this video, you'll be able to understand a few of the questions that I've gone solved. And it is not only helpful for CAT, but almost all the other exams to solve it really fast. So let's look at some of the questions. Like, a stall sells popcorn and chips. Okay, so we have three sizes: large, super, and jumbo. So they're given the ratio. So popcorn ka ratio is large, super, and jumbo, and chips ratio large, super, and jumbo. So they also mentioned that total number of popcorn packets is same as the total number of chip packets. What we want is ratio of the jumbo popcorn packets and jumbo chip packets. That is the last one. Okay, jumbo is the last, 16 and 14. But first, the condition is that the total packets has to be the same. So if we look at the popcorn packets, the total number of packets becomes 40 out here. 7 plus 17 plus 16 is 40. Same way, if you look at total number of chips packets, 6, 15, 14, add it up, it becomes 35. Now if you look at each number, this is 8:7. But they said that total popcorn packets have to be same as chip packets. To make it same, I have to multiply this by 7 and multiply this by 8. It will be equal. Which means my jumbo popcorn packets will be 16:7. But my jumbo chips packet will be 14:8. And if you realize, they will be equal. 1:1. So automatically, A option. No major equations required, no formulas required, just look at the sum, understand the sum and solve. And normally tell students not to use pen as far as possible, because not using pen helps you to think better. The moment you can think better, you'll be able to solve better and faster, logically. Okay, let's go to one more sum. Price of medium quality mangoes is half that of good mangoes. So you can always assume, shopkeeper buys 80 kg good mangoes and 40 kg medium mangoes. And they said the common price which he sells is 10% less. A good way of solving is to assume the price of good mangoes as 1. Because in the end we want the price of a good mango is reduced by 10%. Reducing the price from 1 becomes easier. So in which case the medium mangoes will be 40:0.5. So total price becomes 80 plus 20, which is 100. Now this is the cost price. Now when I'm selling, I will sell all the 120 mangoes at 10% less. Right? 10% less. Now 9 12s are 108. So this is the selling price. And you can directly make out that the profit is 8%. Not very difficult, will hardly take any time to solve this. Just substitute values and you get the answer immediately. So CAT sums are not normally very difficult. If you understand the sum, you can really solve faster, provided you have a right method to solve. Another sum. This is also similar because you have a discount and a profit percent. 60 iron nickel toys, 40% discount and 20% profit is what she says. 10 of these toys destroyed. So we can assume that 60 toys are each of 1 rupee. Right? So it becomes 60 rupees. Now, but she make a profit of 20%. So profit of 20% is 12, because 20% of 60 is 12. So the selling price becomes 72. Now I want the mark price. The 72 you got after giving a 40% discount. So you can find the mark price by selling price upon 1 minus discount percentage, which is 72 upon 0.6, which is 120. Or you can do by cross multiplication. If mark price is 100, my selling price will be 60 because of 40% discount. If the selling price is 72, what is the mark price? You can cross multiply. You still get 120. So my mark price is 120. When you say mark price is 120, it basically means 2 rupees per toy. Because for 60 toys, the mark price is 120. Now, my 10 toys are broken, so 50 toys I have. 50 toys, the mark price is 100. This is the mark price. But I want to sell it at 72 to make the same profit. So my discount becomes 28%, which is D option. Not difficult. If you put an equation, it will take a little longer time. Just substituting values become faster. If you're comfortable with this simple calculation like 72 divided by 6, 12 8s, all that stuff, this can be done in your mind also, most of the calculations. You need not even write. So be comfortable with simple calculations and you should be able to think logically to get the answers to this. Okay, one more. This is a little more trickier than the previous one. The previous ones were very, very simple, could have been done within half a minute. This is a little tricky because you have to understand it slightly better. Okay, to understand it, let's look at what it is. It is a plus 3 and b given in the first ratio. I'm removing the square root of it. It's 3 and 1, but they have opposite signs. So 1 will be positive, 1 will be negative most probably. Right? I'm not putting the signs right now, I'll put it later on. A minus 1 and b minus 1, if I put, you realize it will be 2 upon 1. Now here, I have reduced the value of a by 4. And reduce the value of b by 1. If you notice, the value of the numerator reduces. Okay, 3 has become 2. The value of numerator will reduce normally when a is positive. Only if a is positive, or here numerator is positive, when I subtract 4, it will become smaller. If a was negative, then the value would have been bigger. For example, if a was minus 4 and I subtract 4 again, it would have become minus 8. The numerically value would have increased, but we know here it is reduced, so we know that ideally a is positive and b is negative. Second is, when you subtract 4, it becomes 2, which is an even number. That means a minus 1 is even because we get 2. So a plus 3 should be also even, because when you add 4, it should be even. So we get the possible cases. One case is 6 upon minus 2. You also have 12 upon minus 4. You can also have 18 upon minus 6, 24 upon minus 8, and so on. So all these values are possible. Now just substitute. So if I reduce a by 4, a plus c by 4, you will get the numerator as 2. And if I increase b by 1, you get minus 3. But this is not 2 is to 1. So not. Take the second case. Reduce by 4 becomes 8. Reduce by 1 becomes minus 5. Again, this is not. Reduce by 4 becomes 14. Reduce by 1 becomes minus 7. This satisfies. So which means I know a plus 3 is 18. In which case I'll get a as 15. If a plus 3 is 18, I know a will be 15. I also know b is minus 6. So which is nothing but 5 is to minus 2. So if I remove square, you will get the answer is 25 is to 4, D option. I hope you understand. You can solve almost all sums if you can solve logically, think logically and go about, and you can really do it fast. I hope this helped. If you, we have solved 4 sums out here. I'll load more videos on this. This is basically for you to understand methods are important, and it's not late to change your methods. Change the methods and you'll be really fast and you'll be able to really solve a lot of sums. Right? Hope it helps. You can go to my videos which I put in the channel. Thank you.